I'm Jerry Masney. I'm local union president of Local Union 7999. We've been on strike since May 18th of this year. The plant is located in Franklin Park, Illinois, which is about 5 minutes away from O'Hare Field. We employ about 350 members that are on strike currently. We've had some people unfortunately cross the picket line, but we're still standing strong. This is our 11th week of the strike, and we'll be out here one day longer.
I'm the District 7 director. Sloan Valve has ripped our contract. They're trying to steal our benefits. They're trying to lower our standard of living. They got no wage increases. They get no peace until they give us justice and we get a fair contract.
Where we used to work at a plant called Sloan Valve Company, and they make flush valves. They've been in business for around 110, 108 years. The reasons why we are on strike are the high insurance costs that they're trying to impose on us. They're trying to make a family pay $9,000 out-of-pocket expense before some of the insurance kicks in. They're imposing a strict attendance policy, which we don't think our members will be able to adhere to. They want to bring a temporary labor force in for our higher skilled jobs, for our tool room jobs, for our maintenance jobs, and for our other higher skilled jobs. They want to bring in this company called ATS, and they want us to train these people and without regards to seniority for our people. It's just a ridiculous proposals that this company is putting on the table. We have 350 members. We've had some unfortunately cross the picket line, but we're still standing strong. This is our 11th week of the strike, and we'll be out here one day longer.
My SOAR chapter, Steelworker Retiree Chapter 31-9, is based at the old Republic Steel in South Chicago. And we met up there at the Union Hall this morning and brought a couple caravan up here to support the Sloan workers, the Sloan Valve workers who are on strike. We're an activist organization. We are a part of the labor movement. When our union calls, or when any labor people call, we try to show up and we try to fight. Right now, what's going on is Sloan Valve is just being very hardcore, going after all the cuts, doubling the health care benefits for these workers. These workers are on the front lines for all of us because, you know, this corporate campaign against workers and unions is just going full blast. So anytime there's a chance to get out there and raise a little hell with these companies, that's what we like to do.
Jason Osborne, 6787, Burns Harbor, Indiana. Brought my kids out here to show them what the union's about, show them what solidarity is. Someday they're going to be fighting for their contract. I want them to learn early so they know what we're going through so they can retire someday happily.
No contract, no peace. No contract, no peace.
Hello.
Thank you.
Do you want a sticker?
Pick it up.
You know, you can't continue to give companies profit at the sweat and the feet of the employee. There has to be a give and take, and obviously Sloan Valve does not want to give. So people here have been here for a long time. You know, they've worked long hours, they've worked extra days, and there doesn't seem to be the Sloan brothers. I guess the company's owned by their brothers now. The father passed it. And there doesn't seem to be an appreciation of all the people that are here that that they're being compensated for that.
Currently, our average salary is around $20 an hour. There was no wage increase that was put on the table. It was put on the table, but the company withdrew it early in negotiations. The workforce there that was presently there or was there in the past when we were before the strike, we probably produce upwards of $2 to $3 million a day in sales for them. And payroll was probably somewhere, I don't know, in the $700,000. So the company was, you know, for a weekly salary. So the company was definitely doing well. They've been in business a long time, 108 years, and they refuse to negotiate in good faith, in my opinion.
This is an important fight. Every struggle where workers are battling to maintain standards around pay, benefits, job security is vitally important to all workers. Workers in our economy have been under attack for a long time, and we need unions like Steelworkers and Local 799 to bring the members together and take a stand and fight for what they deserve. And we are proud to stand alongside them in the struggle, and we will continue to be alongside the steelworkers until they prevail with Sloan Valve.
I pay taxes in Franklin Park. Who's watching? Who's watching my streets, my neighborhood?
That you got paid to take care of our citizens, not to pay the rich people. You just care for the money, for the rich people. You don't care for the regular folks. They pay taxes every day.
What happened, Maggie?
Well, you see all the police officers are over here. How about Franklin? They're supposed to be taking care of them, not over here.
This company is watching us. And every time somebody crosses, they say it's weakness. They don't have enough to run that plant yet.
No more scabs!
No more scabs!
No more scabs!
You guys have got to stay solid.
No more scams! No more scams! No more scams! No more scams!
We are leafleting the Ace Hardware store in the suburbs of Chicago. We're asking customers as they come in not to buy Sloan Valve products. Currently, this Ace Hardware store sells many Sloan products, many repair parts that we make at our plant. And we're asking consumers not to buy those products because of the strike that we're conducting against the company. We are planning to do many Ace Hardware stores. We have been doing many Ace Hardware stores where they sell Sloan Valve products. And we're going to continue to boycott until the company comes back to the bargaining table and gives us a fair and equitable contract.